My name's Lamek Banda, coming from Chainama Seventh-day Adventists. And I'll be taking you in first aid honor, of which there are levels of or parts of first aid. There is part one, which is basic, part two is standard, and then there's also advanced. But for today, we'll be looking at the basics of first aid. So we need to understand what is first aid. So first aid, by definition, is the first help that you give or the immediate care that you give to someone who is suddenly injured or becomes suddenly sick, in order to promote quick recovery, preserve life, also to prevent the condition from worsening. The first aider is a person who's providing the first care or the initial care or the immediate care to someone who is injured or who has become severely sick. Okay, that is the first aider. Okay, so what are the aims of first aid? The aims of first aid, the first one is to preserve life. Okay, at all costs, you need to preserve life. That is the sole purpose of this first aid. Okay, then the next one is you need to prevent the condition from becoming worse. How do you prevent the condition from becoming worse? Let's take for instance, if someone has injured himself and is bleeding. So for you to prevent the worsening of that bleeding, because if a person continues to bleed, he or she might bleed to death. So for you to prevent that from worsening, you need to bandage and do other measures to stop that bleeding. So, okay, so in first aid, there are rules. And these rules, you can easily remember them by the acronym DANGER. DANGER is the acronym for the rules of first aid. So DANGER, D is for danger itself, A is for ABCD, then N is never, G is get, then E is to examine, then R is reassure. Okay, so let me just explain a little bit on these words from this acronym DANGER. So the first one is danger. Danger for what? Okay, so if a person is injured or has become very sick, we need to be aware of the dangers. Danger to that person, also danger to the first aider himself or herself, and then even for other people who may be bystanders or onlookers. So we take for example, a snake has bitten a casualty or someone, and the snake is still there. So for you as a first aider to start attending to that person, you really need to assess for danger. Is a snake there or it has left? Okay, if it is still there, then it means you need to remove the casualty, that person, from that danger. And you need to be mindful as well as a first aider, because it can also bite you in the process of trying to help the casualty. Okay, we move to the second one, which is A, which is very, very cardinal in first aid. A, B, C, D. Okay, A is airway, then B is for breathing, then C is circulation, then D is the degree of consciousness. So when we talk of airway, first things first, the Bemba say ubumi bwa muntu bwaba mu pema. So you need to really check the airways. Which ones are the airways? We are talking about the nose, as it goes down the trachea, the bronchioles, into the lungs. That is the respiratory tree. So if there is any blockage to this respiratory part, then someone would not breathe well and they may faint or they may die. So we really need to attend to these respiratory parts. So the first one is the airway. You need to ensure that the airway is clear. So how do you check that the airway is clear? You need to check in the nose if there is any blockage or any secretions that you need to remove, any foreign parts, so that the airway becomes clear. And then if someone is lying down unconscious, then you need to do the what we call the head chin lift. More like you are taking the head a little bit backwards so that the airway can be opened and this person or casualty can be able to breathe very well. By doing that, you are preserving life and promoting recovery to the casualty. Okay, the other one is B, which is breathing. You really need to restore breathing. If the airway is okay and the person is not breathing, then you need to help this patient to breathe. And for you to check if the patient or the casualty is breathing or not, you can look at the chest, if the rise and fall of the chest, if there isn't that action, it may mean that someone is not breathing. Then the other thing is you can get a small cotton and maybe try to put on the nose or the mouth and see if there is any action to show that someone is breathing, okay? And if someone is not breathing, this is where we come in and give the help, which we call CPR, cardiopulmonary resuscitation. You start compressing the chest as well as giving the breath. This we are going to learn later in our lessons. I'm just more like introducing you to first aid, okay? So the next one is circulation. Circulation, what do you understand by circulation? Circulation, the things that are involved are the blood vessels and the blood, okay? So we need to, you need to check pulse. The pulse, and if there's any hemorrhage or someone is bleeding. Is someone bleeding? Is the pulse okay? So I'll give you the readings for the normal pulse so that you know if it is abnormal, if it is maybe above the normal or below the normal, then you will know what to do. If someone is bleeding, then you need to attend to the bleeding. For example, you may bandage so that blood stops coming out, because if blood continues coming out from this casualty, it may mean that the blood pressure will become very low and the pulse will be very rapid, very fast, very abnormal. So you really need to attend to this casualty. Then the last one on A, there is D, which is the degree of consciousness. So degree of consciousness, you need to evaluate this casualty. How conscious is this person? How alert are they? Okay, are they unconscious or are they conscious? So you may check, you may call them and they'll give you a feedback or no feedback. Then you can also touch them to see if they can feel you, because even the eyesight, are they able to see you or to hear your voice? Okay, so you really need to assess and then give appropriate treatment to the degree of consciousness.